Some years from now, on a parallel Earth, humans will have their own unique story to tell. There are billions of stories being told everywhere, all over the world. That is until something happens. Events that can change us all, remind us that we are human, different from other species. These events can take our lives in different directions, shape us. In the year 2020, a most amazing advance in exploration was going to take place. Mankind going back to the moon. The Russian billionaire, Vasily Afanasy, he announced his shock news that his rocket was going to go up in 2 days' time. Many people anticipated this to be a breath of fresh air in a very gloomy decade of austerity. It wasn't until the rocket left our world and ventured into the heavens that we discovered the truth about a lie that had been so long kept forgotten. The truth about how the Van Allen radiation belt would affect humans that travel through it. This lie was revealed in excruciating visual form. But with these astronauts' deaths, we were able to begin a new age of scientific discovery. The maverick professor, John Sylvain, through such amazing innovations in science, such as the Higgs boson, the ghost particle, and neutrinos, Sylvain was able to create two super beings able to travel through time and space. He was given the funds and means to work on the project Superhuman. This project was designed to help human beings travel beyond space and time, to find new worlds to colonize and to live on. Our world was becoming far too populated and polluted. Mysteriously, before his project was completed, Sylvain was murdered, and he never got to see his creations brought to life and awoken. In the year 2050, they were released on an alien world. The group of elite scientists watched and marveled at their creations as they escaped from the watership. It was truly a momentous time. And then suddenly, the giant monitor screen they were looking at changed to the face of Amelia King. Amelia King, I find hard to believe, is actually my mother. The only trillionaireess, she, the bitch, is unstoppable. But how did one person gain so much power? It all started years ago at the Roswell crash site. It was here that alien entities known as 00 were able to infiltrate the site. Like a magician's trick, they made everyone look one way while they were sneaking in the back door. With the power of Area 500, they were able to shape the very history of man. From secret meetings with presidents to moon landings filmed at Area 500. They truly were very powerful. But it all came at a price. With the financial crash that happened in 2008 and the Euro crisis that followed, a very unscrupulous banker named Edward King found his way to the top. One of the few that willed for the system to fail and gained from it. With his underground connections, Edward King was able to take control of Area 500 in an unholy alliance between the alien entities 00 and Mr. King began. But it was his daughter, my mother, that would become so infamous. A fat cat, too obese for the rest, with riches and power beyond anybody's comprehension. We fought against the tyranny of the Trillionaires. Millions were lost in the fighting. She took so much from so many of us, including me. She had to be stopped. Through the use of Sylvain's work, a few of us were able to gain powers like the superhumans. We used them to fight her unnatural armies. Failed. It was futile. Now, all our hope rests with these two super beings. Little do they know that millions of miles away from them, on a small planet, the survivors await their success. Maybe we can find other worlds to find happiness and live on. So many people wanting them for all the wrong reasons. It's not going to be an easy journey. The future is uncertain. For all of us.
I was not created with the intention to ridicule this cardinal.
Ach, ich verstehe es nicht.
Thank you. y abrazándote muy fuerte por lo frío que está mi amor. Yo sé que estoy soñando, yo sé que estoy soñando. Despiértame en San Francisco, la ciudad donde está mi amor. Abrir mis ojos y ver su cara y amarla. Con
Yeah! Ladies, this is not a male bashing song. But men, you need to step your game up. I mean, seriously. Met him a few days ago, down the road. He was like, girl, you got it going on. Asked me for my number, but I said no. You should just let it go. I tried to walk away, he followed me. Kept on approaching me, calling me. Told him I'm too good for you, too small for you. Definitely too fine for you. Can't you see me?
Production. We're here at the premiere of Tomorrow When the War Began. We're here with Miss Rachel Hardwood, everybody. Thank you. The film has won several awards already in Australia, including Best Soundtrack, Script and Best Film. What would you put this success down to?
I think it would be a combination of hard work and talent, because everybody that worked on the film was very committed and dedicated to their job and really good at their job. So that sort of attributed to the success of the film.
Okay. How did you get involved with this project and what drew you to it? What made you want to go after it?
I'd read the book when I was 12, so I already had an inkling of what the story was about. I enjoyed it very much when I was 12. So coming back to it, it sort of had that sense of nostalgia immediately, and then I'd really drawn into the story, the teenagers, their moral implications of what was going on and their decisions and the fact that they didn't know what to do. Because quite often in films you've got a situation like that and everyone seems to know exactly what to do and they have no qualms about doing all these things that might pose ethical problems for people. So that really drew me to the story. The Corrie character, I thought, was wonderful, the way she interacted with everyone. And so I became involved when I auditioned here, and the tape got sent over to Australia.
How do you think the film compares to the novel? You said you read the novel when you were younger, so how do you think the film compares to the novel?
I think it's a really good adaptation, because it's always so hard to kind of go from book to screen like that, because you don't know how many people you're going to upset if they were big fans of the book to start with. But I think, you know, as long as you keep the sort of integrity of the story, which I think this does, then I think you're okay.
Having seen the finished project, what is your overall opinion of the film?
I really like it, and I'm so proud of everyone. It's so funny seeing all these people who I became so close to, that watching them perform and doing such a brilliant job on screen. Mm. So I just love that aspect of it. For me, it was just amazing.
And finally, tell us why we should go and see you when Tomorrow When the War Begins.
Tomorrow When the War Began.
I'm sorry.
No, that's all right. Just seen it. Yeah, I think you should go and watch it, because it's got so many different elements to the story and different aspects. There's so many different parts of it that are just so wonderful. It's a really, really great story, great characters, and I'm in it, so.
If that's not enough reason, we don't know what is. Thank you very much,
Thank
Rachel
you.
Herbert.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
Thank you for your time, and stay tuned to Real TV Magazine for more news.
Aya Heights Youth and Community Organisation has been in existence since 2007. What we do is provide activities and provisions for young people within Haringey. Some of the projects we've done so far: football, personal development, gardening. We also have an advice and guidance service. which operates 3 days a week from Chestnuts Community Centre. And our latest venture is this social enterprise where we provide employment for young people in easy to learn trades such as window cleaning, gardening, removals, decorating and any other odd jobs that may need doing. So the scheme is designed to engage with them, then we can assist them in getting back into education, employment or training. So the enterprise scheme is really a tool of engagement.
For the stars, then you can't get through to me. I'm busy with the bars, like very soon I'm gonna be topping all the charts. Yeah, I am so close, no I'm not that far. I aim to be the best, nothing more, nothing less. I've got that A-level flow, you can put me to the test. And I'll bet I'll pass it with flying colours. I am on a higher level, no I'm not like these brothers. Like name another artist that can spit like this. And I'm a shooting star, when you see me make a wish. And when it comes to the weight, I don't struggle, I just lift. Cause my flow's heavyweight, I'm adapted to this. I'm something like a circle cause they know me around. And if there's money around, then I'ma be around. Yeah, I keep recording them big hits at wordplay. And my tracks are fly wide cause they get airplay.
Yeah.
my back, but I'm flyer than the others. Yep. And they cannot see me like I'm undercover. Nah. I'm nice with the flow, I'm tight with the bars. And ask the astrology, I'm up with the stars. Yeah, real, recognize real. This tune's for the real people, cause I keep it real. And I stay on point, I'm sharper than the sword. I got the keys in my hands, it's time to open doors. I keep it moving every day, I don't stop for a pause. Don't fear anybody, cause I walk with the Lord. Yeah, I'm too focused, nothing's gonna go wrong. Trying to find my destination with no tom-tom. Stop there, hold on fam, one sec. Can you smell that? I smell success, yes, and I'm allergic to failure. It's real life, no cartoon, Tasmania.
The higher I climb,
the higher it gets.
Yeah.
Where I'ma keep reaching for the stars,
the stars.
Reaching for the stars,
the stars.
Reaching for the stars till I get it.
Hello and welcome to Real TV Film Production. We're here at the premiere of Tomorrow When the War Began. We're here with Miss Rachel Hardwood, everybody. Thank you. The film has won several awards already in Australia, including Best Soundtrack, Script and Best Film. What would you put this success down to?
I think it would be a combination of hard work and talent, because everybody that worked on the film was very committed and dedicated to their job and really good at their job. So that sort of attributed to the success of the film.
How did you get involved with this project and what drew you to it? What made you want to go after it?
I'd read the book when I was 12, so I already had an inkling of what the story was about. I enjoyed it very much when I was 12. So coming back to it, it sort of had that sense of nostalgia immediately, and then I'd really drawn into the story, the teenagers, their moral implications of what was going on and their decisions and the fact that they didn't know what to do. Because quite often in films you've got a situation like that and everyone seems to know exactly what to do and they have no qualms about doing all these things that might pose ethical problems for people. So that really drew me to the story. The Corrie character, I thought it was wonderful the way she interacted with everyone, and so I became involved when I auditioned here and the tape got sent over to Australia.
How do you think the film compares to the novel? You said you read the novel when you were younger, so how do you think the film compares to the novel?
I think it's a really good adaptation, because it's always so hard to kind of go from book to screen like that, because you don't know how many people you're going to upset if they were big fans of the book to start with. But I think, you know, as long as you keep the sort of integrity of the story, which I think this does, then I think you're okay.
Having seen the finished project, what is your overall opinion of the film?
I really like it, and I'm so proud of everyone. It's so funny seeing all these people who I became so close to, that watching them perform and doing such a brilliant job on screen. Mm. So I just love that aspect of it. For me, it was just amazing.
And finally, tell us why we should go and see when Tomorrow When the War Begins.
Tomorrow When the War Began.
I'm sorry.
No, that's all right. Just so you know. I think you should go and watch it, because it's got so many different elements to the story and different aspects. There's so many different parts of it that are just so wonderful. It's a really, really great story, great characters, and I'm in it, so.
If that's not enough reason, we don't know what is. Thank you very much, Rachel.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
Thank you for your time, and stay tuned to Real TV Magazine for more news.